I'm Crystal, and this is Kelly, and we're doing a video today to demonstrate how to do eye gaze with people who have communication difficulties. So this here is an example of an eye gaze frame that can be purchased from a variety of different vendors or even created on your own at a workshop. It's kind of like a thick plexiglass, and at the bottom here is just a piece of wood, and it's got just a little slot in it that you can kind of slide this piece of plexiglass in here. But there are other ways that you can use an eye gaze frame. You can use some low-tech ways, like the inside of a picture frame. So the matting, the picture frame matting would be useful, or anything else that you can find that is plastic and that you can affix symbols to. You can use that to get yourself started. So today we're going to do an example of using eye gaze for Mr. Potato Head. All right, so up on here I have put Kelly's choices on the eye gaze frame, and on the back I've just written for your purposes what the different choices are, and on the reverse side you'll see that the symbol, the picture communication symbol, is there for her to see. So what we're really asking her to do is take a look at the choices that are present, and to gaze at a particular choice for a designated amount of time to indicate what her preference would be. So, hi Kelly, we're going to do Mr. Potato Head today. Let's take a look at our choices. We've got eyes, hat, mouth, and nose. I wonder which one you would like to do first. I see you looking at all your choices. I see you looking at eyes. Yes, and Kelly did something that was really quick. She looked right back at me to let me know that that was in fact what she was looking at. So she was confirming what I was identifying as her choice. So that's called confirmation of choice, and that's just a way to indicate, yep, in fact, that's the one. So I think you want eyes. So you can take that choice off and you can give her the eyes. Excellent. And then you can just replace the choice with another one. So we'll give her ears. All right, let's take a look at our new choices. We've got ears and hat and mouth and nose. What would you like next? I see you looking at hat. Oh, good job. And she looked back at me. And if they don't look back at you, another thing you can do, you can say, I see you looking at hat. Look back at me to let me know I've got it right. And if that is still tricky, you can kind of pick up the symbol and go and bring it to your face and say the same thing. I see you looking at hat. Do you want hat? Just to help train that confirmation of choice and that eye gaze back to the communication partner. All right, let's give you the hat. Wonderful. All right, so we've got three more choices. Got ears, nose, and mouth. What would you like next? I see you looking at mouth. Can you look back at me to let me know I'm right? Thank you. All right, we're gonna do mouth. Here you go. Only two more choices. So you can leave them up and down, that's no problem, or you can just flip them around and move the choices left and right, depending on what works best for your kiddos. All right, we've got two more choices, nose and ears. I see you looking at ears. Can you look at me to let me know I'm right? That's right, ears. Let's put the ears on. And then the last one is nose. Wonderful. Let's put the nose on. Great. So that's just a quick example of how you can use eye gaze to get your kids who use this method to communicate and make some choices and participate in a fun activity. Thanks so much.